Hi everyone, I'm Kelly with Chicago Movie Tours. Today is our first Friday Focus, and I'm coming to you from LaGrange, Illinois. That is where we have been for the last few days, talking about Chicago's relationship to film. On Wednesday, we looked at two locations in LaGrange, Illinois, that were used in the 1995 romantic comedy While You Were Sleeping. Thursday on social media, we looked at the LaGrange Theater, which is directly behind me here, and a contest that was held there in 1966 to accompany the Disney movie, The Ugly Dachshund. And today, I would like for us to consider LaGrange, Illinois' relationship to the 2002 film musical Chicago. So Chicago is a 1926 play written by Maurine Dallas Watkins. She actually wrote the play as a homework assignment while attending Yale Drama School. For those of you theater buffs out there, you probably already know that Watkins' play is the inspiration for the 1975 stage musical Chicago, starring Cheetah Rivera, Gwen Verdon, and Jerry Orbach. What you may not know is that there are three film versions of Watkins' play as well. The first one comes to us in 1927. It's a silent film entitled Chicago. The second one is 1942. It is entitled Roxie, Hart and stars Ginger Rogers. And the third one is the 2002 film musical called Chicago, starring Renee Zellweger and Catherine Zeta-Jones, which is the one that we're going to talk a little bit about today. Again, most of the characters in Watkins' play are based on real-life women from the 1920s. In fact, a new book that was released in 2020 called He Had It Coming, Four Murderous Women and the Reporter Who Immortalized Their Stories, tells the stories of these women from Chicago. So one of the supporting characters in Watkins' play, as well as the 2002 film adaptation, is a woman from LaGrange, Illinois. I have my trusty clipboard again. Here she is. Her name is Mary Wazeniak, and she ran a speakeasy in LaGrange during Prohibition. So the story goes something like this. In 1923, a local man went into Mary Wazeniak's speakeasy, which was basically her house and her living room, and ordered five or maybe six different drinks. So he went in there, he imbibed with the drinks, he left the establishment, walked about 200 feet, and fell dead. An autopsy later indicated that he died of methanol poisoning, as Mary Wazeniak used wood alcohol in her booze. So at this point, Mary is 34 years old. She's a mother of three. She has a husband who was, quote, permanently ill, as reported in the newspapers. Considering women's position at this time, and considering specifically immigrant women's positions at this time, Mary was probably just trying to make ends meet since she had a husband who was unable to support her by opening this speakeasy out of her own house. Nonetheless, she was arrested and tried. The jury was out for about 30 hours debating her case, and she was sentenced 1 year to life in Joliet Penitentiary for Women. At this point, she is now known as Moonshine Mary, and she's the first bootlegger in Illinois convicted of selling poisonous moonshine. The Chicago Tribune consistently reports this line in addition to her name, Moonshine Mary. Quote, Mary was born in Poland and speaks little English, end quote. This brings us back to the 2002 film musical Chicago. And if you're already familiar with the film, you probably know which character Mary Wazeniak is based on. During the cell block Tango number, one convict speaks only Hungarian, and she's the only one convicted, despite her being innocent. So what can we deduce about LaGrange, Illinois and Moonshine Mary and her representation in the movies? So first, let's consider her nationality. In real life, Mary Wazeniak is Polish. In the film, she is Hungarian, which signals her immigrant status. Also, she speaks no English or little English, so she cannot defend her actions. She cannot defend her story, even if she were innocent of the crime. Second, let's turn to representations of women in movie history. So the character type we are dealing with in the movie Chicago is the femme fatale. Now, femme fatales are dangerous, seductive women who usually get the men that they are associated with in quite a bit of trouble. If you're familiar with the genre film noir, which comes to us about 1940 and leaves around 1960, depending on which scholar you're talking to. Film noir is littered with film fatales. And generally in those films, because they are dangerous, because they are seductive, they need to be punished in some way. So they often are, several of whom are punished by death. So in movies like Chicago, in which you have a femme fatale who gets to walk free at the end, usually there's a character in the film that has to be sacrificed in order to let that femme fatale go. In other words, so the murderess can go free, you need to have a scapegoat in the narrative. And in this case, the immigrant who does not adhere to the prescribed Chicago woman or the Chicago American becomes the scapegoat. So is this fictional representation in the movies based in any truth in American society? I'll leave you to answer that question over the weekend. Until next time, I'm Kelly with Chicago Movie Tours, and I will see you next week with another Friday Focus.